See what you missed last week at Calvary Tabernacle.
Trying to do this by myself. I can't do this. I would end up saying like Paul, oh wretched man that I am. When I would do good, am I preaching or am I not? When I would do good, evil is present with me. All my righteousness is like filthy rag. I'm glad Luke wrote to me and tell me, don't try to do it. You've got to get the blood applied. You've got to get the name applied. You've got to have God's help to make you better. I need 50 folks in the house. You are better, not by yourself, but by the blood of Jesus. You are better, not by yourself, but by the grace of God. You are better, not by yourself, but by the mercies of Almighty God. Clap your hands and say, I'm better, I'm better, I'm better.
Just shall live
for you.
We serve a mighty good God. He is no God like no other. Nothing can compare to my God. Somebody look at your neighbor and say, God has been so good. Somebody look at your neighbor and say, God has been.
Mighty God. He's a savior. He's a ruler. He's everything you need him to be. Could we just lift our hands as we sing this song? Is our God, is our God.
Great and mighty is our God, is our God. Great and mighty is our God, is our God.
We sing that again. Great and mighty is our God, is our God. Great and mighty is our God, is our God.
Ruler, ruler is our God, is our God.
He's a ruler. sing.
You are greater
than anything.
Than anything.
As we lift our hands, give you praise. You are greater. God is bigger than it. Sing,
you are bigger
than anything.
Than anything.
Oh, you are higher than anything.
Than anything.
Oh,
God is greater and mightier than anything. Hallelujah. Before we go into prayer this morning, just a quick announcement. There is a Burgundy Lincoln MKZ license plates GSL5683. Your window is down. So if that is your vehicle, please take care of that immediately. Lincoln, MKZ, GSL 5683. Hallelujah. Let's get into prayer. Hallelujah. As we go into prayer this morning, there are many needs, there are many wants. If you look to the screen, there are the names of the individuals who have made it known that they need prayer. But I'm absolutely sure that there are many more who need prayer. So as we go into prayer this morning, I want us to just meditate on the names. But not only on those names behind us. Meditate on all the needs that we may have, all the needs that anyone we know or even don't know may have. Our God is faithful and He's mighty and He can perform. Hallelujah. Let's pray. Our precious almighty God, we thank you, O God. How excellent is your name in all the earth. My God, your name is higher than any other name. How sovereign is your name. How great is your name, hallelujah. Father, we thank you this morning. We thank you for the opportunity, almighty God, one more time to come together as a body, as your sons and daughters of Christ. We know, almighty God, that it's not, almighty God, by anything that we have done, but it's by your grace, almighty God. Even the simplest first breath that we took this morning, almighty God, to wake up, almighty God, is as a consequence of you. It is you who created us. It is you, almighty God, that has breathed your breath in us, almighty God. Many times we take it for granted, oh Lord. But now, this morning, as we seek to worship you in spirit and in truth, we thank you. We say thank you. Hallelujah. Father, there's so many things, almighty God, is going on right now. As we pass through a season of loss, a season of mourning, we can be comforted, almighty God, that you are with us, almighty God. You have been our rock through everything, almighty God. You have been the shield, almighty God. You have been that hiding place, almighty God. You have been that refuge that we could seek, almighty God. So we thank you. Father, we pray for all those needing healing this morning. Father, wherever they are, almighty God, whether they be in your sanctuary this morning, or they be in the hospital, or they be at home, almighty God, touch them this morning. Almighty God, the names are many, but you know every name, almighty God. Right now, almighty God, be that Jehovah Rapha. Be that healer, Almighty God. Touch them wherever they are, Almighty God. Dispatch your angels of healing, Almighty God. As you said, you can do, Almighty God. Touch them, Almighty God. Heal them, Almighty God. Father, we know, Almighty God, that healing, Almighty God, it's already done, Almighty God. So strengthen the faith, Almighty God, of those who are ailing this morning, Almighty God. Strengthen their faith, Almighty God. Healing does come through faith. Hallelujah. So we thank you. We want you to touch every medical personnel, Almighty God, in those hospital rooms. Touch every caregiver this morning. Almighty God, no one knows your ways, Almighty God. And you can use anyone, Almighty God, to heal, Almighty God. So, Almighty God, we pray this morning that your spirit, Almighty God, your presence, Almighty God, it will surround, Almighty God, those in need of healing this morning. Almighty God, there is nothing that you cannot do, Almighty God. We open our hearts and we open our faith, Almighty God, to you so that you can do what you have to do in your mighty name. Father, we thank you again, Almighty God, for this service. Father, as we seek to worship you in spirit and in truth, Almighty God, let us put away, Almighty God, all our earthly and all our fleshly needs, Almighty God, and all our earthly and fleshly objectives, Almighty God. Let our spirit and our mind be clear, Almighty God, to receive you, Almighty God, to receive your Holy Spirit, Almighty God, so that whatever you needs to be done shall be done in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we pray this morning for the service, Almighty God, and every other congregation this morning. Let us unite, Almighty God, in your name, Almighty God. We may not be united physically, but spiritually, through your spirit, we shall be united as the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. So, Father, do your word this morning. We pray for this service, Almighty God. We pray for our leader, Almighty God. We pray for our bishop this morning and his family, Almighty God. Continue, Almighty God, to bless him and his family, his children, Almighty God. Father, embrace him, Almighty God, in those times that he needs embracing, Almighty God. Father, let there be peace, Almighty God, that surpasses all understanding, that peace that defies all logic, Almighty God. You are capable of that. We pray for our pastor, Pastor Stewart and his family. Father, continue, Almighty God, to bless him. Inspire him, Almighty God. Father, continue to download into him, Almighty God, everything that he needs so that your will be done, Almighty God. Father, it is all about you in the mighty name of Jesus. We lift your name up this morning. We declare, Almighty God, that we are sons and daughters of Christ. Hallelujah. We speak your name this morning. We represent everywhere that your name cannot be spoken. But right here in Calvary Tabernacle, we are declaring the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So we thank you this morning. We honor you. We glorify your name. Let your will be done here this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, we honor you, and we glorify your name this morning. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Praise the Lord, Calvary. Praise the Lord. Our lesson, scripture lesson for today will be taken from St. John 7. We will begin at 25th down to 52. We're going to read one after the other. And it begins thus. Then said some of them of Jerusalem, "Is not this he whom they seek to kill?" Howbeit we know this man whence he is, but when Christ cometh, no man knoweth whence he is. But I know him, for I am from him, and he sent me. And many of the people believed on him and said, "When Christ cometh, will he do more miracles than these men, this man have done?" Then Jesus unto them, Yet a little while am I with you, and then I go unto him that sent me. Then said the Jews among themselves, Whither will he go, that we shall not find him? Will we go unto disperse among the Gentiles and teach the Gentiles? In the last day, that great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried, saying, If any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink. But this spake he of the Spirit, which they that believe on him should receive. For the Holy Ghost was not yet given, because that Jesus was not yet glorified. Others said, This is Christ. But some said, Shall Christ come out of Galilee? So there was a division among the people because of him. Then came the officer to the chief priests and Pharisees, and they said unto them, Why have ye not brought him? 46 are together. The officer answered, Never man spake like this. Glory be to God. Here ended the reading of God's holy word.
You may be seated. Praise the Lord, Calvary. Praise the Lord, Calvary Tabernacle. Amen, amen. Welcome to this morning's service. At this time, it is my pleasure to welcome, take a moment to welcome all our visitors and our guests. If you're a first-time visitor or even a second-time visitor, I want you to stand. We want to give them a Calvary Tabernacle welcome. All right, all right, all right. Thank you, thank you. We have visitors over here. Give them a Calvary welcome, guys. Praise the Lord. We are so glad you chose to worship with us today. And if you're tuned in for the first time on YouTube or Facebook, we welcome you. We'll give you a virtual high five on Facebook. Amen. All right, so please listen keenly to the following announcements. Okay, this is your last call to reserve your seat for Youth Congress. Youth Congress, July 25th to the 29th at the Dome at America Center in St. Louis, Missouri. Okay, so it's going to be, we have our Exodus young people, we have our TTG young adults, and we need chaperones as well. So please, this is our last week. We need to solidify our numbers for Youth Congress. So please, that's going to be an awesome time. See me after service. I'll be right over there to either add your name and let me know, okay? So please, let's do that today. Amen? All right, so today after church is our March family dinner. We invite those with last names starting from H all the way through M, and we're going to join us with their guests upstairs, okay? So who was at the first family dinner from A to G, right? Who was it an awesome time? Amen, amen. So we're going to have a great time today as well. Letters starting from H to M upstairs after service. The next dinner is going to be April 23rd for those with last names N through Z. Please reserve your space for the next dinner with the church office. Okay, we know what's happening in spring, right? Easter is coming. Easter is coming. For our Easter campaign, we will need your help to reach our Easter goal of 1,100. 1,100. Is that doable, Calvary? Is that doable, Calvary? Amen. 1,100. We're having two services, the first one at 9 a.m. and the second one at 12 noon. So please submit your commitment cards. We have commitment cards in the back. Please submit your commitment cards today in the offering, and we need your influence to make it happen, right? We're empowered to influence, and this is where we show it forth. Amen? All right. So we also have exciting news. We are upgrading our church management system to better serve our members. The new system will give each member real-time access. Let's say real-time access. Very good. Praise the Lord. Real-time access to their giving information, personal profile, and church engagement activities. So later today, we'll send out a text with the link for the app so you can access it and make sure your personal profile is up to date. And we're asking all members to help us update their membership profiles before next weekend. This Tuesday will be Bible study. Join us at 8 p.m. on Facebook. And if you would like to become a member of this great church, our new members class is open, led by Elder Vish and Minister Kayon. And please ask an usher for more information about that. Please like, comment, and share our content on social media and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Follow us on all social media platforms and keep updated. Enjoy the rest of the service. Participate and be blessed.
It's official. The National Youth Congress of America returns in July. Join our youth and young adults for a four-day trip to St. Louis as we join thousands of apostolic young people in a time of empowerment and renewal at St. Louis Arena. Registration is open.
Somebody put your hands together. We've come to bless the name of God in this place. Something about the name of Jesus. Yeah. Come on, put your hands together like this. Come on.
Change it. Change the way we call God. Somebody give God a great praise if you know there's power in the name of Jesus. Tell me who can stand before us when we call on heaven. Hear you. People of God that know the power in the name of Jesus, so open up your mouth and just call on the name of Jesus with me. There is power in the name of the Lord, and we sense that your presence is here, God. Jesus, Jesus, hey, Jesus, there is something about your name. Can somebody help me sing it? Master, Savior, Jesus, like a fragrance after the rain. Somebody call his name, Jesus. 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 Let all heaven and earth proclaim kings and kingdoms. Raise it up high.
Extra time we give to you this morning. An extra
let's sing an extra praise. There's something about your name. There is something about your name too powerful to comprehend or understand. Hey. You're the God of all creation. You may be seen in this presence if you can. Something about you, Jesus. Somebody came this morning because your heart is full with thanksgiving and praise. There's an opportunity we have to come before Him. But there's something about this great name. We feel that there's something. You see, when I didn't have nobody to call, there's something. The healer of my disease, yeah. Something. See, this is the atmosphere where you can be healed. This is the kind of atmosphere where you can be delivered. This is the kind of atmosphere where somebody, oh, just give me one more minute. When I call your name, Jesus, about that name, there is something. You, God of heaven and earth, we exalt you. We exalt you. There's nothing more powerful and more wonderful to come into a place where you can feel God's presence. I want to thank all of you on behalf of our bishop that's here in the sanctuary this morning. Because this is the gateway, this is the window to heaven. And I sense that God's presence is already ministering to the needs that you may have. We just want to quickly move. I took up some time, so I'll make this piece shorter. We just want to thank all of you that supported the Thomas family as they went through their time of loss. Can we put our hands together for this great family, this great household of faith? To Aldika and the kids that are here, we are continuing to pray for you and pray your strength and comfort. Amen. How many know it's a wonderful thing to be a part of a church family? And during the funeral, it was so wonderful to hear what her friends were saying about you. Because they said, when you talk to Aldika, there's nothing like her church. Her face lights up and she beams with pride. And I'm so thankful that we were able to be there for them in a very difficult time. Amen. Continue to pray for them. As most of you heard, she lost her husband in a very tragic motorcycle accident. And he leaves behind her and four children. So life definitely will be different. But how many know we serve a God that is a comforter and a God who is with us and a God who can be with us? But we also are part of a great family, amen? And so we promise and commit to be there for them as they go through this time. We also just want to recognize some friends that are in the house. The Watsons are here this morning, so we want to celebrate you. Thank you to see you, sir. The whole family's here. As well as Kia and Leka from our trip to Israel. They're here this morning. Amen. So we had a wonderful time journeying to Israel together. So it's good to have you in the house of the Lord with us. We just want to make a quick shout out before we're preparing you to give. I'm going to ask Elder Vish, Elder Walters, Lady Janice, and Minister Judith to come and stand behind me real quickly. As you prepare to give, if you need an envelope, the ushers have them so they can hand them to you. We are giving church, and we know because when we give, we are blessed and highly favored, and also it gives us an opportunity to give back to a God that has been good to us. But I just want to quickly do this while they prepare you. I just want to say on the heels of Elder Sermo, if they could put the names of those that have committed to go to the trip with us. Youth Congress is a very special thing that we have done over the years. And there's no better thing to do than to take young people across the country and have a great time of fellowship where we get together. They bond, they unify, and we are able to fellowship with almost 11,000 young people from around the country and around the world. In an auditorium, in a stadium, just worshiping God together. So these are the names that have committed so far. We have a few more spots left. So again, if you'd like to go, please see Elder Sermo or Sister Felicia after the service. Again, we are not late, last minute people. So please get on board because the ship is about to leave. Can somebody say amen? We also want to reiterate and amplify that we have a goal of 1,100 for Easter Sunday. Everybody say 1,100. I need more help in here. I said 1,100 for Easter Sunday. Between the two shifts, 9 and 12, we need your help to fill this auditorium with worshiping people that have come to the realization that He is the only God that gave His life and rose again. Amen. And so last year, we were able to meet the goal of 1,000, and so we've amplified that to 1,100. Everybody say 1,100. So for that to happen, we need to engage everybody in this process. You've been given cards. Did everybody get them? Okay, so we're asking you this morning. We gave them last week. We're asking you, if you did not fill them out and turn them in, we need them today. Please turn them in as you come down with the offering. And next week, we'll be showcasing those that are our platinum bringers, our gold bringers, our silver bringers, and our bronze bringers. But on the heels of that, I just want to give some feedback. I want to thank all of you that came out to canvas and participate in our boots on the ground effort. Put your hands together for all those that participated in the effort. I'm so thankful to all of you. It's been our first time since coming out of COVID. We've tried to engage in this way. And I appreciate all of you that responded to the call. You came out. We spent an hour and a half going into the community, reaching out to people. And I thought I would share real quickly. They only have 30 seconds each. But there were some immediate responses from this. And over the years, this was a very strong strategy that we had. It was started by Lady Golson. First Lady Golson, and we adopted streets. I don't know if many of you remember, but starting in February, we would adopt streets in the community, and every Saturday, we'd have a large contingent going out to different parts of the regions of Hempstead and evangelizing and witnessing to people. And I believe that God is about to re-engage and reunite us afresh again. Amen? Amen. So the next canvassing will be next Saturday at 10 a.m., and we're looking for double the crowd to help us to do this. The Bible says, he that winneth souls is wise. So I just want to get them to give some feedback, and then I'm going to ask Elder Walters to end this segment. Real quickly, you have 30 seconds each. Just share with you one of the things that happened when they went on the street.
Praise the Lord, everyone. So just really quickly, we encountered quite a few other people, other churches that were also reaching out and evangelizing to the community. In particular, two individuals that we came across. One person said that she came to Calvary years ago. In fact, she came at the time when the church was a storefront and they were fellowshipping with Pastor McKee. I think he used to have services here, and I may be mixing up the name, but years ago. And she did not know. She lives in another state right now, but they recently transitioned her mom to a nursing home here, and so that's why she was in town. So she hadn't seen the new building. So she was very impressed and happy to see the growth and saw what God was doing, and she promised to fellowship with us the next time. And also, we encountered a gentleman that has been with the village of Hempstead all his life, and he said he remembered before the storefront was even here. And again, he talked about, you know, just the growth in the community. So the strategy that we took was that we're just not a church, we're changing the community. We're beautifying the community, we're also set up schools because we believe in better education. So we're really marketing the church. So we need everyone to talk about what makes Calvary so special. Because there's really a lot of things that we're doing that you don't realize, but people are watching and people are seeing the growth that's happening here. So we just encourage you guys just to be a part of that experience.
Praise the Lord, everyone. It was good to be out yesterday with everyone as we went out. As Pastor said, it was, as we discussed after, it was good to get into the spirit of evangelism and get that back up. We did encounter a lot of people, other churches out there. So in this community, there's several churches around here in the proximity of probably 5 miles. There's so many other churches. But we know what God has called us to do and to be. We're the center of influence. We're the center of apostolic activity here in Nassau County. So we're not competing with everyone, but we have a message that the world needs to hear. And there were another church, they had about 50 people out there, and they were on the ground. So we were excited to know that God is doing a great work here at Calvary, and we are ready to go all in and all out. So join us next week as we go out into the community.
Amen. Put your hands together for Elder Bishop. And I'm going to have, I want you to receive our Elder Walters, who's in charge of evangelism. So put your hands together for him. Amen. As he comes, I will echo Elder Vish. That church in particular is serious about soul winning, at least in this way, because they have been out there in the snow, in the cold. In fact, they even tried to win me to the Lord. And I felt very guilty about what we are not doing, because standing on Mars Hill in Athens, Greece, where Paul preached his first revival, I realized that we have a lot of work to do, and we must be the salt and light of the earth. Amen. Elder Walters.
Praise the Lord, everyone. It just takes one invitation. And I'm very excited to know that we have initiated this move in getting out there in the community. There is someone who needs Christ. There is someone who needs someone to reach out to him or her. Praise be to God. So I'm encouraging you to come on board and let us increase the number as we expand the spread from within the city of Hempstead to go beyond Baldwin. We go Westbury. We go Garden City. Come on, is there somebody who's excited to go out and to stretch this wide and far? And there's one thing that I commit myself to, is that when I'm reading, going through this initiative that was initiated by Lady Golson, I hold on dearly to it, because I can see the effort that she had put in this initiative. And of course, this is something that we should embrace, and let us, in honor of her, let us give support and drive this initiative that we can go out in the community wide and far. And also, for those persons who we know work on a weekend, we are asking you to get involved as well. We will be using the digital invitation cards. So we're asking you to send it out to persons who are within your circle, that you can also participate. And also, your prayers for those who are going out. God bless you. In Jesus' name.
Thank you, Elder Walters. And you should have received those by text. So today you have the opportunity to share the message on your different platforms and spread the word. Also, lastly, to speak on this effort, we were having a Zoom call with the leaders, executive directors, and our leader of the pastoral ministry was very passionate about this goal. And she was so passionate, I said, you have to do the final rallying call. So please receive it this time, Minister Judith Garrick, as she comes.
Thank you. Praise the Lord, church. So I wrote a speech because of what he gave me. But I did not go canvassing yesterday because I, whatever. But I'll be going next week with my entire family and relatives and all of my little section there that I have influence over, which I haven't cleared with them yet, but I decree and declare it is so. We are going out next week. So I wanted to tell you something. Yes, I am here to sell you a passion. The church has a need, and the need must be met next on April 9th, 2023, a day known to you as Easter Sunday, but celebrated as Resurrection Day. That is the day when Jesus Christ defeated death. He got up from the grave. He got up and he got out, giving us a hope that we will defeat death. So, with that said, our 1,100 goal seemed a bit scary at first, but we did it already. We did 1,000 already. So in a combined service, we can definitely do 1,100. It's all about planning and being strategic. So let me tell you, it's 550 persons per service. Now, Easter, as I was telling on the call, Easter is a time when, before COVID, everybody and their mama wanted to be in church. So now I have questions for us. If you are a Holy Ghost Easter baby, let me see you wave your hand. You are here, or you got the Holy Ghost, because someone invited you to an Easter service. Please put your hands up. Janet Roach, please put your hand up. Where is Candy Simon? Simone, I see you. All right. If you are hooked on church because someone invited you to an Easter service, let me see your hand. So we have more on the numbers. So please don't tell me that we cannot do this. Each person needs to find at least 5 people. If you go after 5, you'll probably get 2.5. Find them and let them know that you need them to come to church to worship God with you. I'm telling you, change your language, change your verbiage. It's come to Easter Sunday. They have choices. You need them to come here to sit beside you and worship God. You speak with authority because you are empowered to influence. Try it. I promise you, if 3 says no, the other 2 will say yes. Go after them. You know where they are. They're your friends. They're in your phone book. They're on Facebook. They're everywhere. You let them know that you want them to come with you to celebrate Resurrection Day. Go out and tell them to come and worship God with you. See you and your friends.
All right. Thank you for that pitch. Thank you so much. And lastly, I'll say this. We're about to receive the offering, so I'm assuming by now you all have... I don't see the line over here. You can give by ATM as well. We're about to receive the offering. But last thing I'll make on this is, it's not enough just to get them in the house. How many know we need to get people saved and filled with the Holy Ghost? I said, how many know we need to get people saved and filled with the Holy Ghost? So we're very intentional in this season. And we've set up a very special thing that we're doing called Holy Ghost Infilling. It's going to be a session that will first start with a Zoom call with Mother Terry Richards, who lives her life for this. And so on next week's Saturday, everybody say next week's Saturday, we're asking all those that would like to hear more about the Holy Ghost infilling and what that truly is about. If you've wondered or questioned, we're going to have a Zoom call. She is in Washington, D.C. She'll be joining us via Zoom. We're asking her to do this special thing with us. So please jump on the call at 7. Also, our altar workers, we'd love to have you on the call at 7. And at 8 o'clock, we'll shift into more altar workers training. And then next week, the day before Palm Sunday, again on Saturday at 7 p.m., there'll be in-person altar workers session. And on Palm Sunday, we're looking for a tremendous outpouring of the Holy Ghost in all of our 3 services, in this service, or 2 services in this service, and as well as the children's church. Can somebody say amen? Amen. Well, it's time to give, and we have found that we serve a God of abundance. How many know He is the God of abundance? Amen. Amen. Are you ready to give? I need more help in here. I said, are you ready to give? Amen. 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 Indeed, God is wonderful to us. And we thank you for being a part of a great church. Let's look and tell somebody, I just love being a part of this great church with you. Come on. Look at the other side and say, I just love the fact that you're a part of this great church with me. Amen. All right, we have found that when we give to the Lord, He gives us good measure, pressed down, shaken together. And there are 4 ways that you can give. As you heard, we are transitioning from faith life
but you can give by Zelle, you can give by check or by money order or cash, and you can also give through ATM here as well. We found out that the God of heaven, he will prosper us. Therefore, we his servants will arise and build. These are not debts that we sow, but these are seeds that we sow into the kingdom of God, and that promises a harvest as we do so. If you're not already standing, can you stand to your feet? We're about to receive our offering at this time with gladness and boldness. And I don't know about you, how many are a witness that when we give unto the Lord, he does truly bless? I need more help in here. Can somebody shout that you've been blessed and highly favored because you are faithful in giving unto the Lord? So we are excited, and we believe that as we give to the Lord, he will rebuke the devourer for our sake, and our supply will never be empty. Let's go to God in prayer. Dear Father, we thank you this morning for the opportunity that we have to be in your presence. The opportunity we have to be in the land of a living and alive in this moment to worship you and praise you in spirit and in truth. And as we come into your presence, oh God, we recognize, oh God, we have this opportunity. So we come with boldness, we come with gladness, we come giving of ourselves. And these offerings serve as a symbol of our desire to serve you and bless you. Because who are we as human beings to bless the great God of heaven? And we realize as we do so that you'll pour into our lives and you'll measure back to us, good measure, pressed down, shaken together. So we come with gladness, and we decree and we declare that these offerings are blessed. Our finances are blessed. Our homes are blessed. Our children are blessed. Our communities are blessed. This church is blessed. Can somebody give God a great praise as you come with celebration? We're going to ask you to march this morning as you come giving of yourselves and giving of your offerings this morning.
Praise the Lord, saints. We know who we are in the house today. Anybody know who they are today? Praise the Lord.
Chosen generation, all for to show his excellence.
it for me. And because you're the God that orders every step that I make, you may be seated if you can in his presence. Amen. We just want to say before we get to a very exciting part of the service. Somebody ready for an exciting part of the service? Amen. Those that are in the aisle, have you been given your tools to use? Can I see them? All right, I only see half. All right, I need more. I need to see everybody. That's all they have them? All right. All right. So we just want to also welcome back Minister Stephen and Minister Nicole that were traveling. Amen. We wanted to thank God for giving them journey mercies that she went to bury her father, and we're thankful that God was faithful to them. Amen. So good to have you home. Amen. We just also want to recognize and let you know that Sister Claudette is out of rehab and home, doing well. So that is indeed a victory report. God came through, and God kept it all together. Amen, as he always does. We also want to let you know that Elder Allen lost his brother, and those funeral services will be next weekend, the 25th. And so please continue to pray for that family as they go through this time of loss. It will be at St. John's Methodist Church, 2105 Stewart Avenue, Valley Stream. And we'll have more information. Those of us that can go to support them, that's what we do. Amen. So Elder Allen is always there for everybody else, so we will need to be there for him as well. And then Elder John is in need of your prayers today. So as we mentioned earlier, we want to ask you to continue to keep him in your prayer. And Elder Seeley and Brother Alex are traveling back from burying her sister in Guyana. So please keep all of our folks in prayer as they go through these different times that they're facing. Amen. But indeed, we've come to a very special time. It is our Right Hand of Fellowship segment where we introduce all of our new folks that have joined us. So I need my pom-pom wavers. I need a good song. Can you just stand and receive the new members to Calvary Tabernacle as they come? Oh, yeah. Marcia Wright, and all those that work with the team. They do such an awesome job welcoming in new guests, welcoming new members. And if you are, you may be seated. If you are here, you come regularly, look and tell somebody, we'd love for you to be a member. Yeah, even if they are, tell me, we'd love to be for you to be a member again. Some of you took a break during COVID, so we'd love for you to be a member again. Please receive at this time Elder Vish and Minister Kian as they come to share and present to you our new members.
Praise the Lord, everyone. Amen. It is such an awesome day. I'm always excited to greet and bring the new members. It's wonderful to work with them, to hear their story and where God has brought them from. It's exciting to hear what God is awesome. And His kingdom is much bigger than these four walls. And He's doing an awesome work here at Calvary and around the world. Can you just stand, come on, and make the devil mad and said, come on, look what the Lord has done. Come on, come on. I think that's for Calvary. But if you do it for Jesus, I think it should be a little louder. Amen. Amen. God is good. And we all know we have been here at some point, and they have their struggles. They have their trials and tribulation. Many of them could have given up. Don't come to the class. Don't go on Zoom. But they pressed through, and they're here. We're in Apostolic Church, and they are baptized in Jesus' name. Come on. We believe in here, O Israel, the Lord our God is one. We believe in one Lord, one faith, and one baptism. And His name is? There is no other name given. And that name is? Amen. When we are baptized in His name, what happened? Our lives are transformed. Any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Let's look at somebody. Are you baptized in Jesus' name? Come on. Say it with boldness. Because that name has power. Amen. We here at Calvary, we have a responsibility to go into the world and preach the gospel to all creatures, all nations. That's our responsibility. And I will read for emphasis. Our mission is to preach the gospel to the whole world, beginning in Nassau County, compelling all to come to Calvary, the way to God. As an apostolic center, our purpose is to disciple all to become like Jesus, our Lord, and to involve them in the work of the ministry, where their talents and their gifts, their abilities can be used to advance the kingdom of God here on earth. And as my wife called their names, I want you to celebrate them as pastor and them, give them the right hand, and Bishop, give them the right hand of fellowship. I want you to celebrate them for what God will and has already started in their lives.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So as I call the names, Pastor will start on this side and give them the certificate. Teresa Airline. Myrtle Brown. LaVon Edwards. Irene Edwards. Serge Gorge. Charles Harewood. Carlene Harewood. Abigail Harewood. Charles Jr. Harewood. Susan Javis. Kelsey John. Anita Tatum. Yashen Murphy and Michelle Smith. Can we celebrate them?
It's also Charles Jr.'s birthday today. Is that true? Happy birthday, Charles.
At this time, our bishop is coming to give a charge to our new members. Can you receive our bishop as he comes?
Let's stand and give God praise. Come on, let's give God praise. Amen. The Bible says, you may be seated. Heaven rejoice over one. How much more should we rejoice today? The angels rejoice over the fact that we have received salvation and they have no clue what it is to be saved. But you and I who know what it is to be saved, delivered, loved, I'm giving you one more chance to out-rejoice the heavens today. Tell the angels, be quiet for a while as we celebrate these. Amen. God bless you. The Apostle Paul said, having received the grace that God gave him, and watching those that he brought into church, it was appropriate to extend the right hand of fellowship to these. What God has started in your life, we cannot do anything but endorse. So when we give you the right hand of fellowship today, we are shaking your hands, giving you full authority to exercise all your gifts, all your callings, all your talents in the kingdom of God. Not just Calvary. Everywhere you go hereafter, you represent Christ and his kingdom. And this local church, the subset. Be careful that and understand that your lives are living epistles, seen and read of men. When you walk out your house to come to church, your neighbors see you. So you can't make too much quarrel and fighting at the home. When you're on the job, they know you go to church. You represent Christ everywhere you go. We're proud of you. We're happy for you. And as the leaders come, we're going to extend to you the right hand of fellowship. And we are excited for you in Jesus' name. And all these young people, can you give God praise for them as well? Amen.
We are a family.
We are a family. Elders, would you come quickly?
That's been through so much shame. We stand together through the sunshine and the rain.
Together as one family.
So we must pray.
still we love each other so.
When in trouble,
when in trouble, on our knees we go.
Now I'm just gonna give you, 30 seconds just to hug one of your family members and tell me you love them. Let's hug one person or two people. Just tell me you love them. Tell you love them. Tell you love them. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Tell you them you love them. Thank you, new members. Thank you so much. If anybody gives you trouble, please let me know, okay? Thank you. You may be seated.
If wrong or right,
if wrong or right,
still we love each other so. When in trouble,
when in trouble,
on our knees we go.
We're about to hear the word of the Lord. Thank you this morning for your patience. We're not usually this long, but we always are excited to be able to do this and welcome new members. Can you put your hands together one more time for our new members? Amen. Well, with that said, it's now 11:57, and I'm so blessed in my life that I have Bishop here to walk us through the different challenges that we face. Amen. So we don't want to remind you today after the service, please don't leave. We just have about an hour dinner that we have upstairs, free food. If you're a guest here today, you're welcome to come up. And if your name is between H and M, we invite you to come forward as well. Amen. Before he ministers, the praise team, it looks like they've conspired something together here. We'll be ministering, and the next voice you will hear will be our bishop with a word from the Lord to this morning.
God, any river you think are uncrossable. God, any mountain you can't tunnel through.
Like a mountain,
faith will.
Come on, if you believe that, clap your hands. Come on, clap your hands if you believe that. Amen. Let's stand together for reading the word of the Lord. We greet Pastor Stuart and Lady Janice, the elders. This is indeed the day the Lord hath made, and we've come to rejoice and to be glad in it. Hallelujah. Glory to God. John 7:37. In the last day, that great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried, saying, if any man thirsts, let him come unto me and drink. He that believeth on me, as the scriptures have said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. But this spake he of the Spirit, which they that believe on him should receive. For the Holy Ghost was not yet given, because that Jesus was not yet glorified. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for your call and for your anointing, and we beseech you to let your glory rest upon us today. Not only upon me, but upon those that will hear me today. We ask for your kingdom to come, for your will to be done in this service. And around the world, wherever your gospel is being preached and your name is being declared, let your kingdom come and let your will be done. And we will give you the praise and the glory, because it belongs to you. And all of God's people say, amen. You may be seated. If they get me on the clock, I appreciate that. We're taking the text today to lift for your consideration some things about Jesus that needs to be declared. When we open the verse, John says, in the last day, that great day of the feast. To properly understand that, we need to know what feast he's talking about and what the last day represented. For those that are familiar, in Leviticus chapter 23, Moses wrote to us and told us about the seven feasts that Israel was commanded by God to celebrate. Every time I talk about the feast, I like to remind the saints, our God is a party God. He just don't get drunk like some folks. Just don't lose himself like some folks. But he loves to celebrate. I don't have much time, but I'd like to find out who in the house loves to celebrate. We have enough to cry about, but we got much more to celebrate. God gave us these seven feasts because he wanted Israel to celebrate everything that he did for them. It is fitting to say, every time God does something for you, you need to celebrate it. I still see some faces that are not happy. And so I got to conclude, God has never done anything for you. If God has ever done anything for you, can you celebrate him? So seven feasts are listed in Leviticus chapter 23. The first three of the feasts, they call them the spring feasts. And we're getting ready to begin that celebration in a couple weeks. The first one, the Passover, that was given to celebrate the fact that God miraculously brought them out of Egypt after 430 years of slavery. He told them to kill a lamb for a house, and to paint the blood on the doorposts. And when the death angel passes by, when he sees the blood, he will pass over. Every house that did not have the blood applied, the firstborn was slain. The Passover was talking about Jesus and his crucifixion. John said, "Behold, the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sins of the world." Can I remind you that Jesus is the Lamb slain before the foundation of the world? I'm glad this morning I'm delivered. I'm set free. I am redeemed, not with corruptible things as silver and gold, but by the precious blood of Jesus. I love the song. What can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood. Is there anybody in the house that you can celebrate the Passover? God passed over you and gave you mercy. God passed over you and gave you grace. Oh, come on, church. Let's celebrate the Passover. The second feast is the Feast of Unleavened Bread. The Jews were commanded before they leave that they should bake loaves, and no leaven yeast should be placed in it. It should be hard bread, not hard dough bread. Because he did not want it to rise. It is important to note that leaven in the scriptures is symbolic of sin. They should break the loaves, the bread, without yeast, leaven, and they should search their homes to make sure there was no leaven in it. This was given to remind us that Jesus was going to be crucified the Passover, and he was going to be buried. I'm happy today that I've been buried with him in my baptism. I'm so glad I went down in the name of Jesus. And if I'm buried with him, and then I'm going to be risen with him, which takes me to the third feast, first fruits. Is there anybody in the house that understand that Resurrection Sunday happens almost every day since the first resurrection? Up from the grave, my God arose with a mighty triumph over his foes. He arose the victor of the... I feel like I should go to a Baptist church today. He arose the victor of the dark domain, and he lives forever with the saints to reign. Jesus Christ is the first fruits of them that slept. I'm not the same no more. I went down in the name and I got up with new life. My hands look new. My feet looks new. Everything about my life is new. If any man be in, how many are glad for resurrection? How many are glad not only did he resurrect your life, but everything that was dead in your life, he's pumped life back into it. Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and I am the life. He that believeth on me, though he were, yet shall he. And whosoever liveth and believeth on me shall never die." I need everybody that got a new life, a new lease, a new beginning, first fruit, stand up and tell God, "I'm happy. I don't walk the same walk. I don't talk the same walk." These are the spring feasts, Passover, unleavened bread, and first fruits. Then we come to the fourth feast. Right in the middle, we come and we find the Feast of Pentecost. This speaks to us of the birth of the church. Pentecost is 50 days after, hallelujah God, the feast of the first fruits. After Resurrection Sunday, you count 50 days and you get to Pentecost. It was on the day of Pentecost. The Bible said when it was fully come, that God sent forth the Holy Ghost and he filled everybody that was in the house. He started the church on the day of Pentecost. You can't be part of this great church if you don't have a Pentecostal experience. I'm not talking experience in a Pentecostal church. I'm talking about the fire that came from heaven and sat upon each of them. I'm talking about they that spoke in tongues as the Spirit of God gives the utterance. Jesus says, upon this rock, I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. I'm so happy to announce he started his church, and his church is still triumphant. It has been through the fire. It's been through the blood. But oh, thank God we're having the victory. Is there anybody in the church that still got the victory? Yes, the devil comes. Yes, there are crying days. And yes, there are sad days. But there are more good days than bad days. I'm in the church of the living God that he bought with his own blood, that he purchased and gave his name to. That's the feast of Pentecost. Hallelujah to God. Say Pentecost. Now we get to the fall feast. The first three, spring feasts. In the middle, Pentecost. The first fall feast is the Feast of Trumpets. And that speaks to us of the rapture. You see, Israel was doing all these things, and they didn't know what they were doing. There were type, Paul said, and shadows of what is to come. But we understand the meaning because Christ fulfilled everything that was in the law. So they were blowing their trumpets, but they didn't understand what was happening. The Feast of Pentecost, we hear them talk about it, especially those in school, Rosh Hashanah, and we love that September holiday. Say hallelujah. And they didn't know what they were doing, but we know what's happening. It started 10 days when they'll do their soul searching. I got some Jewish friends that don't do right all the time. But every time, just around this time, they want to have negotiation. They want to talk because they have to get things right. I wish the Pentecostal church will have a Feast of Trumpet when we'll get pull aside and make things right. Because I found out it is possible to come to church and don't talk to people that's not down your road. I found out, you don't have to find out, I'll tell you what I found out. It is possible to worship with people that you borrow money from and you don't pay it back. But the Jews knew during this feast, they got to go talk to their mama. They got to talk to their brothers and their sisters. They got to make right with their neighbors as well as make right with God. Hallelujah to God. So we understand that. Blow the trumpet, Joel said in Zion. Sound the alarm on my holy hill. Let all who live in the land tremble, for the day of the Lord is coming. They had this feast to remind them, you can't keep living like the devil and expect to go to heaven. And you need to take a time out. You better get right with God. Come and do it now. Under the blood of Jesus, I'm talking to my old time saints. You better get right. Look down your road and say, get right, get right. Stop holding malice in the church. Stop holding grudge in the church. You've got to forgive them that trespass against you, that your heavenly Father can forgive you and the feast. Can I blow the trumpet in Zion? God is coming, and you better get right. You can't be like the five foolish virgins that have no oil in their lamps. And when the master comes, they try to get in. It doesn't work that way. Get right now. I'm going to put the mic down and see the bold saints that will run two rows down and hug the neighbor you have not spoken to in the last. I'm not a false prophet. And don't let me waste the time. Somebody get up, go make right with your neighbor. Thank you, Brother Tuller. Hallelujah to God. Before you get home today, make right with your neighbor and please make right with God. You don't know when the trump of the Lord shall sound and the dead in Christ shall rise. You don't know when the end is going to come. This trump that is being blown is a get right trump. The next trump is we're out of here. The rapture, the church. We're going to be with Jesus. The sixth feast, number six, the Feast of Atonement. We know that Yom Kippur is the day in which the Jews, for 24 hours, they don't eat anything. Complete fasting. And they do this after 10 days, the final day. They are nervous because they don't know if God accepted their repentance. They don't know if they are like Esau, who sought God for repentance with tears and couldn't. They don't know if the words of their mouth and the meditation of their hearts were acceptable by God. You see, we like to believe because we say, Lord, I'm sorry, he accepts it. Because some folks say sorry, but it's a worldly sorrow. It's a sorry because they got caught. Not a sorry because their hearts have been pricked and their conscience have been stirred because somebody looked at your Facebook page and saw them half naked. Somebody showed up at the club that they thought nobody else would come to. All right, go on, Bishop. In typology, the Day of Atonement is a day of judgment when God will judge the world for sin. Now we come to the last feast, the Feast of Tabernacles. And time will allow me to go in, but on the Feast of Tabernacles, the Jews on this feast day would move out of their homes and live on the tents. Because they were using this feast to let God remind themselves that God brought them through the wilderness, brought them through the desert. And they wanted their children to know what God did when he delivered them from Egypt. Sometimes we always seem to forget where we are coming from. And this feast was designed to remind them that God has done something marvelous for us. And this world is not our home. I like to think of it this way. I like to say like what John says. It reminds us he's gone to prepare a place for us. And if he goes and prepares, he's coming back. I know you got your nice house, but that's not it. So every now and again, you got to come out of your comfort. And so you don't get settled in what you have achieved in this world. But you put yourself in remembrance that better is coming. Woo! You don't settle for what you have gotten on this side of the sun. You start look with expectation for that which is to come. Can I announce there's a better house? I'm not just talking a physical house. I'm talking a spiritual house. There is a better body. An incorruptible body. I wish I had a praiser in the house to give God praise for the better that's coming. The Feast of Tabernacle was designed to remind us we're just pilgrims here. We're going through, but we've got another land in view. Beulah land is what we're looking for. We're believing God for higher ground. Now, so this feast lasted for 7 days. On the last day, the eighth day, after the feast was over, the Jews will assemble themselves in the tabernacle. And the priests will go down by the river and will fill some jars of water. And he will come in the temple and pour the water out on the altar. During these 7 days, the Feast of Tabernacles, it's the last reaping time. And so they'll gather all the fruits. How many know harvest? Hallelujah. How many been in a church where they had harvest? And they'll gather all the fruits. And they'll celebrate God because this is the end of the fruit season. And it's pointing to us that there is the coming of the Lord that's about to come. Points to the 1,000 years when Jesus Christ will return and rule and reign over the world with his saints. So they were eating, they were celebrating, they had a lot to drink, a lot of celebration. It's on this day that Jesus stood, this last day of the feast, the last of the seven, on the last day of the seven. And then he says, after you have done all of that, after you have had your fill, you're no more thirsty, you're no more hungry, he stands up and he says, if any man thirsts. The question is, why would Jesus do that when they were already filled, satisfied with food and satisfied with drink? He wanted them to know, after you've done everything, you still need me. After you have drank everything you can drink, you still need me to give you drink. Because the water, as the woman said at the well, cannot quench the thirst. I need to know if there's anyone in the house have found out there is a thirst in the soul that only Jesus Christ can satisfy. He gives the greatest invitation. If any man thirsts, let him come unto me and drink. He, the greatest inviter, gives the greatest invitation. He has the ability not just to give my family drink, but to give your family drink. Not only to give our families drink, to give our community drink. To give our state drink, to give our country drink, to give this world drink. If any man thirsts, Jesus says, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. He's capable and he's able to satisfy all of your desires. Can I remind you, he has everything that you need. And after you have tried everything, I recommend you try the greatest. His name is Jesus. In him we live, in him we move, and in him we have our being. He's able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that we're able to act or think according to the power that worketh in us. There is nothing too hard for my God. I don't care what you're thirsty for. Jesus can satisfy your thirst. With men, it might be impossible, but there's nothing impossible with our God. He is the greatest. There is none like him. I'm so excited to decree and declare. There's nobody like Jesus. Nobody formed him. Nobody counsels with him. He doesn't need your vote. You can't vote him in, and you cannot vote him out. Does anybody know who I'm talking about? More than 2,000 years ago, the scripture tells us he was born. He lived in poverty. He didn't travel extensively like some of the saints. He never went more than 200 miles away from his house. In infancy, he startled the king. In childhood, he puzzled doctors. In manhood, ruled the course of nature, walking on the billows as if it were a pavement and ushering the sea to sleep. I'm talking about Jesus. There's no storm in your life. No water can swell your boat and sink your ship that my God can rescue you from. He healed the multitude without medicine and made no charge for his service. You don't have to have medical insurance to get healing from the God that I'm talking about. He never wrote a book, yet all the libraries of our world could not hold the books that have been written about him. He never wrote a song, but you hear the praise team singing every Sunday, every day of their lives about him. I need a praiser in the house. I'm telling you, the greatest has given us an invitation that he's able to meet. Hallelujah to God. He never went to college, yet all the schools together could not boast of the many students that he had. Is there any disciple of the Lord in the house? Is there any student of Jesus Christ in the house? Is there anybody still sitting at his feet and learning of him? For he's meek and lowly in heart. And we're finding rest for our soul. He never practiced medicine, yet he healed more broken hearts than all the doctors of the world combined. He never marshaled an army, drafted a soldier, or fired a gun. Yet no leader has ever had more volunteers, hallelujah, than he has. Every Sunday, oh, the world puts people in their, people put themselves in their cars, take buses, take trains. Some people fly planes to get to sanctuaries to worship and adore him. Some people walk, some people ride, some people run, some people crawl, some people are brought, but they come to honor and to adore him. What brought you in the house today? Who came you to see? A greater than Jonah is here. A greater than Herod is here. A greater than John is here. What came he out to see? What did you get up out of your bed this morning to come and find out? Did you come to see if Bishop was going to be in the house? Did you come to hear the praise team? I suggest change and come to see Jesus. Come on, say Jesus. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Somebody shout his name. Hallelujah. He's a husband to the widow, a father to the orphans. He's Noah's rainbow, Abraham's ram, Isaac's well, Jacob's ladder. Who is Isaiah's sundial? Ezekiah's healing, Peter's shadow, and Paul's crown of righteousness. To those that walk in darkness, he's the bright and the morning star. To those that are lonely and walk in the lonesome road, he's the lily of the valley. He He's a rose of Sharon. He's a honey in the rock. He's a pearl of great price and a rock in a weary land. He's the Prince of Peace. He's the King of Kings. He's the Lord of Lords. And he is my Savior. He is the greatest. And he gives us an invitation that you can accept. You won't be disappointed. When you come to him, you won't leave the same way you came. You will drop your bucket, your water pot like that woman. You'll run in the streets and say, come. See a man who told me all that ever I did. Come taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man. Is there anybody that came and you found out he is the greatest? What kind of God is this? He's an incredible God. He's a mighty God. He's the everlasting Father and the Prince of Peace. He is my counselor. Only Jesus can satisfy your soul. Stop running here and there, thinking that anything can satisfy. I love him so much, and this is why, because he allows us the opportunity to try everything. And when we come up empty, he doesn't say, see, I told you, and turn his back on us. Woo! He waits until we run out of options. And then he says, come. He did to us like he did that woman that had the issue of blood for 12 years. She spent all that she had. And the Bible says she grew worse. Tried every doctor. Spent all her money. Waited so long. And then he showed up. How many can testify? I tried too much. I should have come a long time before. If any man thirst, let him come. He waited to the very last day. It tells me you're not going to hell without God coming to you. You're not exiting this world without grace coming to you. For the grace of God that bringeth salvation at the pier. If it's your last day on your deathbed, he'll make a way. If any man thirsts, let him come. Any man, slap yourself on your right knee, say, that's me. You know you're thirsty. Our bodies, 90% of it is water. You can live long without food, but you can't live very long without water. You cannot live without Jesus giving you a drink from the well that never runs dry. As the heart panted after the water brooks, so panted my soul after thee. My soul thirsts. I need to find out who else like David is thirsting for the living God. Give it up. Stop the running here and there. Give it up. Settle down. You know, the elders will agree with me, both males and females. I counsel folks, especially those that are recently married and got young spouses. and you find that sometimes they're not so faithful. It's counseling time now. I say to them, if you love the person, don't walk away. As long as they're not abusing you and they're bringing home the paycheck. Because they can't keep running around forever. Amen. Say, right, Bishop. You got to be like God. Yes. Wait them out. And please don't be like your mama or your daddy. And when they come around, you slap them the door in their face. Uh-oh. I'm in trouble now. Let me get back on the script. I will preach. You got some thirsty husbands. But they're going to find out only Jesus can satisfy the hunger of your soul. Just make sure you got your name on that insurance policy. Bishop, come back on script. Get back on script. A man's life does not consist of the abundance of things that he possesses. You can amass a whole lot and end up miserable. Trust me, things don't matter after a while. And that which you think you need, you're going to find out you really didn't need it. I close on this. Someday there'll come a day when they'll see it. I didn't say it. Pray that God keeps their eyesight. Jesus stood and cried, if any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink. Listen. This is the key. He that believeth on me. When you come, you got to come believing. You must believe that he is. And that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. If you know your need, take your Uber and keep flying, driving to where you think you can be satisfied. But when your money run out and the fun is done, you still got a dad that you can come to. Can I remind you? You got to believe. You got to believe that God can. That God will. And all he wants you to come and say, Lord, have mercy on me. And he will open up your belly and cause rivers to flow out. What are you saying, Bishop? Either believe it on me, as the scriptures have said, out of his belly. Woo! I thought I had to go to the river to get a drink. I thought I'd have to go to the pipe to get some water. I thought I'd have to go to the supermarket to buy me a bottle drink. Jesus said, what you need, I've already given it to you. But you gotta believe that I can open up the river that's on the inside of you. Slap yourself on your belly and say, it's not out there, it's in here. Christ in me, the hope of glory. Say yeah. He made me out of a lump of clay. He fashioned and he formed me. And then he breathed into me the breath of life. And I became a living soul. He's on the inside. Say it. Yeah. Say it. Yeah. If you got Jesus inside of your soul, get up and stamp your feet. Stir up the gift. And say, flow. river flow. Come on, Jesus. Flow out of me. When I lift my hands, flow through my fingers. When I stamp my feet, hallelujah, I've got a river on the inside. I've got water you don't see. But every now and again, I go down on my knees and I tell God I need a drink. Then he opens up my soul and I start to speak with other tongues as the Spirit of God gives the utterance. You can act cute if you want to, but when I'm thirsty, I've got to get in the Holy Ghost. I've got to get in the Spirit. I've got to stir up God. I've got to tell him I don't believe in my circumstances. This too shall pass. I believe in you, and you are the water of life. I wish you had more time. Put your hands on your belly. So stop running. It's in you. He that believes on me, out of the bishop's belly, the pastor's belly, the intercessor's belly. No! Out of your belly shall flow. I feel like Ezekiel. There's water in you up to your ankle. There's water up to your knee. There's water up to your waist. It depends on your belief. The Lord told Ezekiel to measure the water. Depending on your situation and what you're in, you might just need ankle deep water. As you go through life, you might need knee-deep water. Carry on a little further in life, you might need waist-deep water. But there are times when you say like David, when my soul is overwhelmed within me, lead me to the rock. Remind you, there's water in the rock, and sometimes you gotta speak to the rock, sometimes you gotta strike the rock, but you need water so you can take a dive, you can get lost. Do I have any spiritual divers in the house? Do I have any spiritual divers in the house? They that will see the wonders of God, those that will behold the power of Almighty God. David tells us we got to go into the deep. And I've been sent by God not to find the ankle saints. I'm not looking for the knee saints and for the weight saints. I want those that are going into the deep, that believe you can throw yourself. You can throw yourself in the arms of God. You can do like Peter. Step out the boat and start walking on your situation. Come on, lift up your hands and tell the devil, you can't have my praise. You can't have my joy. You can't have my hallelujah. I believe in God. And on the inside of my belly, on the inside of my soul, what I need is already deposited. On the last day, that great day of the feast, The feast that tells us that the world is coming to an end. And God is going to take his church home. He's literally saying, before we complete the end of this world, I'm saying to you, if you thirst, come. All seven feasts came and ended. And on the very last day, when water was being poured on the altar, when the people ate and drank, and they thought this was it, he says, no, you're not ready yet for eternity until I give you a drink. You are not ready to meet God without the Holy Ghost. Not the way the bishop told you from where you came from. Not the way you were taught. You got to believe as the scripture said. Put the tradition away. Search the book. In them you think you have life. And they are they that testify of me. Throw your hands up. Let's pray. You need the Holy Ghost. You need God to regenerate the spirit that he placed in you in the first place. You need him to rekindle his presence in your life. Sweet Holy Ghost. Have your will. Oh, great one, do your work. Mighty Savior, fulfill your word, and we will give you glory. Whatever your need is this morning, I invite you to come. Come quickly out of your seat. Sit to the left, the right, the center. Come on down quickly. Elders, come on out. Come quickly, come quickly. Come quickly. Come quickly. Whatever your need is, come on out. Come quickly. Saints, don't be distracted. I need your participation in your intercessory prayer right now. This might be somebody's last day. This might be the last call for some weary traveler. Come. You're moving too slow. Come, 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 come. Come. Prayer warriors, intercessors, slip your hands up. Saturate the house with conviction. Come. Jesus says, come. Oh, everyone that thirsts, come. Come into the waters. And he that hath no money, yea, come buy wine and milk for the money and without price. Come. Come. Come, come, come. So many things are calling. It dulls the voice of God. Can the prayer warriors magnify his voice to the hearts and the soul of people that's in the sanctuary? Come. Come, you're not too old. Come. You're not too young. Come. 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 Come, come. Come on, church, breathe that name. Lord, send conviction. Come. Come. I need some more prayer warriors. Some more altar workers, come stand before these that are here. Quickly, quickly. Come. Hallelujah. Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy. If you know how to pray, come stand behind these people. Before we let the rest go, come quickly. Come stand behind them. While the altar workers stand before them. Come on, church. Praise team, come on out. Let's lift up our heart praise. Hey, Jesus. If any man thirsts, come. Oh, shande de devos. Hallelujah. Jesus, Jesus. 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 That's the Holy Ghost already. Yes. Open up our spirit, God. Come on, church. I need some more intercessors to help. Hey, get a cheer, please, quickly. Hallelujah. Loose our doubt and our fear. Hey, hey, Jesus. Stretch your hands towards them. These are hungry folks. These are thirsty folks. Give her a drink in her old age. Hey, Jesus. Glory to God. If any man thirsts, if any man thirsts, hallelujah. Come on, church. If you've got to go, God bless you. You are on Facebook singing Tuesday night. If you can spend 10 more minutes, the Lord is doing a work in the altar. Hallelujah. Jesus, come on, lift it up. Hallelujah. Oh, yeah, devotion.